It's an apple pie festival.
Video is dedicated to Dwight Miller Jr.
I am Dwight Reed Miller Jr.
And this story starts in his orchard.
You want to get a picture of this tree right here. That's the oldest living Macintosh tree.
There you go. You have a lot of fun out there and get some good pictures.
He passed away at his orchard in 2008.
Reed's dad, Dwight Miller Jr., I remember him as always saying that his forefathers or forebears were instrumental in helping to start that church over in the center. Part of the reason I think we donate apples for the Pie Festival in particular is it's more than a church event. It's very much a community event.
People of all ages work three shifts a day to get the pies ready in time for the festival.
A lot of these people you never see in church, but they come out to do apple pies.
My name is Michael Griffin. My wife is the minister at this church, and I'm here under duress. On the other hand, we like getting paid.
I'm Susanna Griffin. I'm the pastor of this church, Dummerston Congregational Church. We make 1,500 pies. We make about $20,000 in a day, and it's the reason I'm not part-time. Wonderful people. It's a wonderful church. I'm the envy of my friends. It's full of good people trying to be better.
Everybody has their job and everybody knows what to do.
90 bushels of apples get peeled, quartered, cored, and sliced.
I don't live here now, but I grew up here. My home and my heart is here.
For the 2 weeks before the festival, the kitchen in the church basement is busy as a beehive. They've been making pies here for 43 years. Here's Sally Olmsted. She's 94 years old.
Neat feeling, isn't it?
How long have you been doing this? I mean, over the years.
About 40 years. My wife and I helped start this thing along with Gladys Miller. We made pies for a train group that came up from New York City. And then we decided to be a good moneymaker, so that's what we did.
The school buses would bring them up from the station. And then the train stopped. We couldn't do that anymore. So this is Hazelton, lived right here in Dummerston. She said, why don't we make some apple pies? So that first year, I think they made 150 or 200. I know at noontime, I thought I'd go out and get a pie and they'd long gone. So we increased and increased. And now for, I don't know how long, we try 1,500. Nearly always sell them all.
Gladys Miller is the festival chairwoman.
Ever since we started, we work on this project for 2 weeks, mornings and evenings for 10 days.
They all taste just fine.
Started out with these being made at home before they got the pizza ovens.
peelings. I mean, to the apple peelings.
When they go to the pigs.
First-time volunteers shouldn't expect to start out making pie crusts.
He's a great dough roll.
Great, we need him.
You have to prove you have a good hand.
Everybody was here for this very important announcement. All right, John, important announcement. Congratulations. This message is to let you know that your 2012 event has been selected as a Vermont Chamber of Commerce Top 10 event for the fall.
Yeah. So guess what, folks? You're going to have to be doing this next year.
Every pie's just mounded with Portland apples.
If you put it out and they say, it's too low, they say, no, no, it's got to be higher. So.
Those two are not done.
How many pies going in ovens?
12. A dozen. No, 48 we made this morning. 72 last night.
Yeah. 6 inches taller.
Thrown together for long hours, people tell each other their stories.
I'll tell you what was really cute to see the other morning here, about a week ago. I had about 18 turkeys. And it was this little young deer, you know, fawn that had half size, that was in amongst the turkeys. And he would charge the turkeys, and the turkeys would charge him, and they'd playing with each other.
You said you liked art. I wondered if you saw had seen any like this. They're made out of old zippers and buttons. I'm going to get me a piece of pie to take home.
Sally always lifts people's spirits. What goes best with homemade apple pie? Homemade ice cream.
My name is Randy Hickett, and I help the youth group make their ice cream. I have the easy part. They're outside cranking.
You work and I don't. So are you done yet?
No. Is it any fun?
Yeah, it's fun. Social event.
I'm Josh Doucette. Last year at the Apple Pie Festival, I sold ice cream. I came back this year because it was fun.
I'm Jeffrey.
How long does it take you to crank a batch?
From around 20 minutes to 40 minutes. Not too bad.
My shoulder gets really sore, but we usually have a lot of fun during all of our events and ice cream making, so yeah.
Well, the wonderful thing about this project is it draws in people from all over. The little church up on the hill in Dummerston has a wide following.
The work makes a music of its own.
Sheaves doesn't mean anything. It's just what I've been doing for ever since I started making pies, probably at the age of about 7 or 8.
Each pie maker has her own signature crust.
Thank you.
men put up the sliced pie tent. Pie making never stops.
I'm watching the expert do it.
That's how I do it.
The electricity went off and added to Gladys Miller's worries.
Power went out. We're in darkness. We have to wait it out.
There it goes. They got full power now.
Where do they keep all these pies once they're made?
We put them in the freezer until the freezers are full. And then we put them in cold storage.
Okay. We got apple pies going to storage.
You know how many you got today?
96. Last night was 120. This is probably a fifth of our budget.
To a point.
You know, that we run the church on. It's something we're pretty proud of because, you know, our church is really a really small church. There's not too many more around the state that can say they have a full-time minister. So we got a pretty unique church.
Once the parsonage freezers are full, they store the pies at Green Mountain Orchards in Putney.
This is where we store them, and when we get done, there'll be four pallets that high.
The owners, the Darrow family, gives the church free use of its warehouse cooler.
Okay.
Yep.
With the help of experienced volunteers, everything runs like clockwork. Back at the church, pie making goes on into the night.
No, gotta keep working. It's only 8 o'clock.
Yeah. Everybody gets tired by the end. Yeah, when they've been here since 4:30 this afternoon, it really makes
I take Advil before I come.
Oh, we're still at it.
At the end of every evening shift, Sally Olmsted tells a story.
And so she said to him, "I want to buy some arsenic." He said, "Buy some arsenic? What in the world do you want to do with arsenic?"
Some of the jokes are rated PG-13.
I found out in bed with her husband. And he said, well, let's see now. I didn't realize you had a prescription.
Finally, there comes a time when the last pies go in the oven.
Well, we're finishing up this, but we have enough to finish the number of pies that we're going to make.
There's only 6 more pies that they plan to make, so.
Oh, really?
My mom always made cinnamon rolls. Her last pie dough went into cinnamon rolls, so our last night here, our last baking, we make cinnamon rolls to signify we are done. There's one pan, partly everyone has had some, so.
This is the end. Another season gone. The peeling apples.
Are you happy or sad?
Happy.
It's all over.
Yeah. It's all over. One part is over.
It's all right, I'll carry it out.
How many did we make?
Everybody worked hard. 1,452.
Then it's time for cleanup.
Ammonia gas. I think we're all being gassed. You thought you were going to be blown up, probably. Yeah. Ain't nobody here but us chickens.
Yeah. I hate elbow grease.
I have a large supply of it.
You're lucky.
No, but it really does come off.
You're good.
You have to have a strong back and a weak mind for this. Satisfying job, too, when you get done.
And by the time they're done cleaning, it's time to get the pies out of the freezers.
I'll reach in and get some of these things.
396, I think, right?
Yeah.
If we counted right.
Three trays.
This is 25.
Thank you.
This is number 34, he told me.
You're wonderful.
They open all the protective bags, so the thawing pies will stay crisp.
We forgot. We think it works, but we don't know. This is something we're supposed to do, I guess, every year, but nobody's...
Remembered.
Charlie's job.
This is a true slice pie because it's broken in pretty good.
Pete is 95 years old. He does a lot of the carrying.
Did somebody make these pallets special for the Apple Pie Festival?
Yeah.
Kind of done by a committee.
But it's a successful committee.
They look like they're well designed. They each got this bevel on the bottom for stacking.
Oh, yeah.
We used to get these huge apple boxes. They were cardboard, and they were tough, but they would sag. It meant that the pies were stacked one on top of the other, and even though they were frozen, they often crushed each other on the bottom. But it was a huge ordeal, very heavy, very awkward. And so these trays are just a miracle. There were many more crushed than you could use.
Most of the pies get tucked into church pews to wait the day of the festival. The pie movers make many trips back to Green Mountain Orchards in Putney.
Those are just stacking these in the back of the church so you guys can get rolling.
That's good.
It's a mammoth bake sale with so many people working so hard to keep the church and parsonage running. To pay the bills, maintain the buildings, and they're able to do it with apples from their own town in the Green Mountains.
I always remember just we pile it, it's a great big basket, and we pile this big money in the floor, this big pile. We had a minister that jumped into it, started throwing it in the air. And when
like
we all
Bruce
had,
McDuck,
yeah,
you
we
know?
Sort of had this feeling, but nobody had ever done it before.
We're going down to pick up 300 dozen donuts at Adams Bakery in Greenfield this afternoon. See a box, Teresa? really good cider donuts.
Is it any good?
Some people like cheddar cheese with their pie.
Is it good?
Oh, yeah. Oh, these are ounces, aren't they? It goes up to 2 pounds.
Yeah, show me how you wrap it.
Okay, so I gotta ask, how much cheese is there?
280 pounds.
They cut, weigh, and label all this Grafton cheese in one night.
So that's... No, wait a minute.
Selling pies early for the people who come to breakfast and don't get back into the center later on.
Even Gladys Miller finds time for the pancake breakfast put on by the fire department.
Okay.
Just helping out because I go to the church sometimes. But I wouldn't say every day.
Pi Day worship is short and sweet. Gladys Miller plays the organ for every Sunday worship. And Pi Day is no exception.
Are you going to be the organist today?
Yeah. Like every Sunday. Yeah.
The Miller Farm, I know best the farms that are connected to our church. The Miller Farm is one of Vermont's oldest continuously operating family farms. The Millers have been farming here since before Vermont became a state. And their 626-acre property is home to 23 historic structures and hillside orchards now heavy with fruit. And since the Pie Festival began, they have given us the apples. All around you, you see the fruits of the Miller Farm.
Bless their crops of grain and fruit, vegetable and fruity trees.
The service is over. The pie sale begins. Motorcycle clubs from all over New England find their way to Dummerston for the Pie Fest.
We're about to ring the bell. It's just the tradition in terms of starting the Apple Pie Fest. Well, hold on, guys. We've been doing this for years, and we're just awaiting the official word.
Ready to ring it?
Go. Ready to ring, guys.
Thank you.
Oh dear, that's fun.
Vanilla or vanilla?
Yeah. Vanilla or vanilla.
Okay, well, I'll decide later.
Right here?
Yep.
Good morning.
That's my strawberry sugar.
Not everyone who works the pie festival is at the church.
Do you have anything other than apple? And we say, no, they're all apple pie. It's an apple pie festival. They're so funny. It's really funny.
Hey, thank
have a great
you,
day.
Enjoy. We're from Holden, Mass. This is our first year. We definitely will.
Connecticut, Columbia.
Did you come on a bike?
Yes, of course.
You come every year?
First time.
Will you come back next year?
Probably, if the pie's good.
The pie sale draws beautiful people from all over.
No cows, just pie.
Where's the pie?
My name is Mesopotamia LaFay, and I'm from Philadelphia. I drove all the way up here with my friend Daniel. Of course, it's a pleasure.
Yes.
We're from New York. Some friends of ours who are in this camp near Bellows Falls.
I'm Carla Maria.
Yep.
Kiwi. Yeah, we traveled up together. I think it'll be an annual tradition.
Exactly.
Hi there, I'm Sylvia London. I'm from Brooklyn, New York. And I just came from Destiny, from the Radical Fairy Sanctuary. Yeah, well, that's what we are. We're a group of radical fairies, and we all just ventured down to bring some of our fairy magic and joy to the people of Vermont.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
All the pies are on the table. This is it. We're almost sold out.
People put a lot of thought into the pie one. They choose.
Hey, this is my pie.
Good choice. Oh, you should feel good about
it. I do. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, that was
I like this one. Everybody has their own little signature.
Wow.
All right. Yeah, we'll take one then.
Get out of here before B gets me.
Nope, this is it. This is it. Out of the 1452, this is it.
Six pies left.
Are you serious? This is it. You made it in time. You want two pies. Four. Don't run over each other. Four pies left. Out of 1,452 pies. Make history. Buy the last four.
We make a pie at the end, the last one, and then take and scratch into the crust the end. I didn't this year, but that's what we've done several years.
This guy bought the last slice.
Two pies left!
Meanwhile, back at the whole pie table.
Two pies! That's it. Those are the only two.
I want them.
Sold! The pies are gone! Ring the bell! Ring the bell! Pies are gone! Woo!
got the last two. Yeah. Yes. The last
Kill
two.
We're complete now.
You keep the change and you keep the cheese.
No pies. No pies, no donuts, no cider.
I want pies.
We have cheese.
I want pies.
So I think that probably covers it.
Bless you with growth and joy and peace. It's a wonderful world. Go in peace.